Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. I'm Nick Barber. Coming up on this week's show, a flying car is cleared for takeoff. More than 500,000 Sony laptops have the potential of overheating. And we learn more about Nintendo 3DS launch plans. We'll start, though, with some bad news about the Microsoft Kin phone. Just 2 months after it launched, it is no more. Microsoft won't continue development of the consumer phone. Launched on Verizon in mid-April, the two models of the Kin were aimed at young people with prominent social networking ties. But reviewers were critical of the phones from the beginning, noting that they are often difficult to use and lacked key features. Microsoft has apparently decided to pin its future mobile efforts on Windows Phone 7, the revamp to its ailing Windows Mobile operating system that is due out on phones later this year. More than 500,000 Sony laptops sold this year contain a software bug that could lead them to overheat. The company has recorded 39 cases of overheating among Vio F and C series laptops since January. Here's a list of the models affected, both inside and outside of Japan. A bug in the heat management system of the BIOS software is to blame. In some cases, the overheating has led the laptop case to deform. Sony is asking users to either update the software themselves or return their laptop so it can apply the update. The fault affects 535,000 computers, although Sony is asking a total of 646,000 owners to update their machines. Nintendo's 3DS, a portable gaming device that can display 3D images without glasses, is coming to the US next year. Many had hoped for a launch by this holiday season, but those hopes were dashed on Friday night when Reggie Fils-Aimé appeared on US TV show Late Night with Jimmy Fallon to promote the device.
And I heard a rumor that there's a 3D Nintendo DS coming out. Is that true?
That is absolutely true.
When is it coming out?
It's coming out next year.
Nintendo is keeping quiet on when it plans to launch the 3DS in Japan and elsewhere. Cisco on Tuesday announced the Cius, a handheld tablet device designed to help users run business applications and communicate in real time. The tablet comes with a 7-inch touchscreen and is powered by an Intel Atom processor running at 1.6 GHz. The lightweight device comes with a front-facing high-definition video camera that can record 720p video at 30 frames per second, and a 5-megapixel camera at the back that can capture high-quality video and still images. The company hasn't finalized the pricing of the Cius tablet, but is targeting a price less than $1,000. The device will start shipping in the third quarter of this year, with general availability in the first quarter of next year. A car, well, airplane, well, flying car that we showed you last year is finally cleared for takeoff. The Terrafugia Transition got a special exemption from the FAA that allows an increase in its weight. The additional weight accommodates airbags, crumple zones, and a protective safety cage. Those features are required by the motor vehicle safety standards, but aren't typically found on light sport aircraft, the category the Transition falls into. The Transition can fly like a regular airplane, then land, fold up its wings, and drive away. A computer rendering of the production prototype will be unveiled in under a month. The company is accepting $10,000 deposits for the aircraft that costs almost $200,000. It should be available sometime next year. When Space Shuttle mission STS-131 blasted off this year, the crew of seven took along tens of thousands of Twitter followers for the ride. In space for 16 days, the crew included NASA astronaut Clay Anderson, who sent regular updates to the microblogging site.
I think it's a very effective way, a very quick way, a very easy way for crew members to relate to people on the ground and tell them the excitement and the spectacular views and the things that we have. So it's a great way to communicate the wonder of spaceflight to as many people on the ground as possible.
Anderson's messages included snippets about his time in space that managed to cram his enthusiasm for the mission in 140 characters or less. I know some of you have been asking for robots lately, so here's your quick fix. At Intel's Research Day, Herb was on show. Herb stands for Home Exploring Robot Butler, and he was assigned to hand bottles to people and then take them back and drop them in a recycling bin. But Herb was good for more than that.
Our goal is to really enable robots to move away from the factory floor, from structured environments like that, into the home. And one of the hardest things about a home is that it's highly unstructured. Things are all over the place. And what we'd like to do, we're building algorithms that can enable these robots to perceive the world, to build really semantic representations of the world, to navigate in a crowded, cluttered environment, and most importantly, to be able to manipulate objects, to be able to open doors, to interact forcefully and physically with the world.
The Herb, who was helping out on Wednesday, is the latest iteration in a series that dates back to 2006. His brain is running a laptop with a quad-core Intel Core i7 processor running Linux with a real-time kernel. Just before research at Intel Day, he got his second arm, and he quickly learned how to take advantage of it. Intel doesn't want to sell robots. It buys parts and builds robots like Herb so it can develop better algorithms. Well, that's our show for this week. Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. Our computer naming contest is closed, but we still need your help. We picked our top five entries, and now we need you to vote for the winner. Log on to our Facebook fan page for more details. The top five entries are Atlas, HyperX, WT-Rex, or World Tech Rex, the World Tech Tower, and the Detonator. Martin Williams will be hosting next week as I'll be out on vacation, so we hope you tune in. I'm Nick Barber, and for all of us here at the IDG News Service, thanks for watching, and we hope to see you again soon.